Hello, I'm Kirsch Mackey and I do hardware design. So in this video, I'm going to go through the preferences in Altium Designer and explain what I can. Okay, to go to preferences, you want to have Altium Designer open, of course, and then you can go to this gear icon, set up system preferences. You can also go to tools, preferences. Either way is fine, but the gear is very convenient. Now there is a lot going on here, but it's really nice how Altium put it together. So let's look at the system. The system's at the top because that's just the entire system. Let's look at our main categories though. System, that's the entire like software, the whole shebang, everything. The data management, this is generally how do you deal with version control for your designs? How do you manage the design in general, the schematic, well, that is this thing. The schematic drawings that detail the connections and the plan for your device. Then the device being the PCB. Next to the PCB, this is the mechanical part. As you can see, it's a printed circuit board. I like these little icons. It's very cute. And then there's the text editors, the scripting system, the CAM editor, which is great because then you can import Gerber files and CAM files and whatnot to see how they look post, or how they're going to look post manufacturing. There's also simulation, which is good. It only has one thing. Interesting. Draftsman settings. You have your certain defaults and everything. Draftsman has to deal with making drawings, professional looking drawings for your PCB. So take, for instance, if I click on here, this is what this looks like. This is a drawing that you would produce for a client and you would have measurements and stuff like that. So that's what Draftsman does. Let's go back to our, let me do it the cool way. Go back to my preferences. Next is multi-board schematic. That's pretty much you make a schematic, but with multiple boards. By default, your schematics would be associated with one PCB, regardless of how many pages you have. So there's the multi-board edition, okay, for the schematic and the assembly. Great. Now that we have the bird's eye view of the different categories, let's look into system. In general, do we want to reopen our last project by default? You may not want to do that. First of all, what is the pros and cons? You can have this check marked, and then you can always immediately start from your project that you were working on last time. That's convenient. But if you're, say, a content creator or whatnot, you may not want to do this. What I do generally is I close the projects, like this is automatically on, and then I close the projects, and then I start a new one, and then I start recording. So it's up to you. Homepage on start. If you don't want your homepage visible and you never really use it, then you can uncheck that. But the homepage is very useful. Let me show you. I'll click apply, then okay. Kirsch, what is the homepage? This is the homepage. This appears whenever you start your software, and then it says you can start watching the videos right in here from their YouTube channel, Altium. Yeah, it's really nice, I've got to say. Yeah, what does get me, though, is that when I watch the video, right, and then I have it playing, here's what happens. I click over here. It's still playing in the background, but I can't see it, which kind of defeats the purpose of the whole thing, right? So if I can move my home page over to the left. Oh, wow, that's really nice. Okay, so just so you see this, it still shows on a separate screen, so that's really cool. You can follow along with it. That is nice, I gotta say. That's really nice. Okay. Now, and when you want to close, it asks, do you want to close Altium Designer or close this window only? Ooh. Anyway, that is the homepage. Let's go back into our settings. I'm on the PCB side, but it doesn't matter. Click the gear icon. We keep going. I'll keep my homepage on start, even though I never use it. Show startup screen. Ah, yeah. This is the cool thing where you see that Altium Designer startup logo thing. It looks really cool. So I'll leave that on. Monitor clipboard content within this application only. Ah, pretty good. So do we want to copy text from, say, DigiKey and whatnot, and then paste it into Altium? I would leave. Or do we want to do that? Like, how do I specify? You have two clipboards. You have the Windows clipboard and you have the Altium clipboard. Generally, just keep this checked so that Altium pays attention to what's copied on your cursor. Like when you highlight some text and then right-click and copy, you paste. Stuff like that. Reload documents modified outside of Altium Designer. Yeah, definitely ask only if document is modified. Never reload? No, that's scary. Alright, that is general. So I'm going to click apply and then go to view. Okay, little bit of glitch there. So now we're back in the view. What do we really care about in here? Not much. As far as the pop-up panels, this gives you a certain delay. Like, let me show you something. So when you have our panels, right, like components, and then you move this to the right window, and then you move over here. This panel is pinned. We undo that pin, remove the cursor off, and it slides back in, right? So how long you hold that cursor over there has a certain delay. See? In certain milliseconds or whatever. Seems like half a second or like a third of a second. Okay. You can change our setting to make that delay longer. You know. Right. And you really have to hold your cursor over it and for longer, and then it'll come up. So there's that. I like to keep it the way it is. Yeah, there we go. Do I want to use an animation? Yeah, I think it's nice, but maybe it makes it more like graphics intensive. Let's see. So if you remove the sliding, it just shoots out like that. I think I kind of like that, but anyway, we'll keep it default. Control tab switches to the last active document. That comes in handy if you want to be like using your keyboard a lot, and that's fine. Is there anything else I really care about? Right, the Altium theme. You can go with Altium Dark Gray. I love the dark gray theme. I'm not changing it pretty much, but you can go to, so you can switch it to light gray, and it says you have to, this is how everything looks. If you like the white or the light gray, that's good, but I like the dark gray. Account management. Yes, I would like to allow connections to Altium on-demand services. Yeah, I like to leave this on, and then I keep the username Kershat Hasofu. Sign me in when I start Altium Designer. Definitely keep this on for convenience, because otherwise, if this is not on and you start Altium Designer, you'll have to log in each time, right? And it gets annoying, at least for me anyway. But if you're in a secure environment, like where security is important, maybe you don't want this on in case somebody, I don't know, tries to mess with your designs. All right. Transparency. When it comes to floating windows, right, we want the high transparency, low transparency, dynamic transparency. What does this refer to? So if you go to components and say we want to right-click and then place this component. Okay, this comes in handy when, let me pop this up. Okay, this comes in handy when you have, let's say you want to place this component, and see that window, this window becomes almost completely transparent, and then you can place the part, or until you place the part. If we change that setting, make your transparency really low for some reason, and you right-click, place a symbol, then it's not that transparent, you see? It's darker. So I like to keep this up. It's fine. And the rest of these and how it affects it, I have no idea. All right, navigation. For navigation, this is important, because it helps you like figure out what you're looking at, and And let's see, just keep everything for the default settings, really. And for cross-select mode is something really special. So whenever you're doing a cross-selection, and that would be under tools, right? When you have your PCB open, let me show you. And you want to find this specific resistor. It shows it on the PCB side, right? And if we go to tools, cross select, it shows that because it's on. If we turn that off, let's see what happens. Nothing. We click on the resistor here, R2, nothing. But when we have to cross select mode on, this helps us isolate that specific thing. To get rid of this filter or cross select, you can right click clear filter to clear that selection. Let's go back into our tool settings. Now, when you are in cross selection mode, you can do certain things like dimming, right? See how you saw how the resistor, the rest of the design got dimmed, and then it highlighted your thing. You can also zoom into the component, objects that can be applied for cross selection, like components, nets, pins, reposition selected component on PCB. Mm-hmm. Yeah. To have this ability to reposition the selected component, you can do Control Shift Y. If you don't want to enable that, then you can just leave it as is. Focus document containing selection if visible. That's fine. You can just play with these and then you'll see some cool things, but that's what that does. Okay. Let's see what else matters here. Enable Document Insight. Okay. Document Insight displays a preview of the document for both the project panel. Hover over the document icon in either location to see the preview. Click on a preview to open the document. So let me show you. Okay. Let me turn this off first so you can see what I'm talking about. When you have your projects tab, you click on the projects tab, right? And then you go here and it shows you the direct location of the schematic page. When you go into your setting, this window is bothering me, so I'm going to close that. All right. When you go back into here and do enable project insight. Okay. So I shouldn't say document insight, project insight actually. Right. I'm waiting for it to do it. It's not really doing what I want to do. So, document insight displays a preview of the documents from both the projects panel and the documents bar. Hover over the document icon in either location see preview. So let's try it again. There we go. Open the schematic reference doc too. I mean, that's cool and all. Maybe it loads it like based on last use or something. But that's Document Insight. I don't know why anyone would really need that. But okay. Sure. Whatever works. And then you can set the delay. Click apply. Then okay. For document tree, mouse hover, don't change the default settings. That's all I'm gonna say. For the projects panel, show document position on project. Let's see what is important here. Single document activates open documents. You can also do single click on, okay, so the projects panel refers to this. How do you activate the projects panel? You go to panels and then choose projects. Okay, so if we go back here, projects panel, right? If you do a single click, you can activate an open document, meaning if you do a single click and the document isn't already open, let's say I close this document, right? I want to close page 2. If I do a single click, nothing happens. I have to double click on it, then open it. Now, when I go back to like the PCB, I can do a single click on the schematic to open it. That's what it's talking about. If you do single click, does nothing, then it does nothing. If it opens and shows document objects from the single click, that would be interesting. I like the idea of it, but that sounds like it could become complicated. So leave the default settings. Components grouping by designated first character, by comment, by owner sheet. That's really cool. Default expansion, source files expanded. So for the default expansion for this thing, I would leave those expanded by default. So I can just see everything, because I don't want to see a folder and then not realize that my integrated library is in that folder, and then I didn't know any better, and it's happened before. So, and I just felt silly looking for my schematic lib file and my PCB lib file under the folder that was collapsed for like 5 minutes, and I was getting upset about everything, and I didn't realize I could decollapse it or uncompress it or whatever. Default locations. So whenever you're working on a project, Altium sets a default document path. Mine is in the public documents Altium and whatnot. This is useful if you have multiple people working on a machine and you want all files and projects to be shared across any account. That's fine. But generally, I don't use public documents. I go straight into documents, okay? So I would change my settings to something else. And also, this library folder is the default folder when you download a part. Let me show you. It's typically the default folder. If you try to get a component and do a manufacturer part search. Oh, wait a second. If you do a manufacturer part search for parts, right? And you look for, I don't know, connectors, something like that. Then you want to right click, download the part. It takes you to users, public documents, Altium 8020 library, blah, blah, blah. And then I have to move all the way to my custom folder within my own project. I don't like doing that, but since because I have this default setting not changed, I end up having to move to my specific project folder. So that's how you can change where the downloads go. Without having to do the extra steps. Okay, for file types. This is the association. It's very nice. For DRCs, this can get a little tricky because for .drc files, I also have ORCAD installed here, right? So I have Cadence stuff in here. And I might want my DRC open by capture. So, it's up to you. For .pcb files, you may have a .pcb file extension and you may be using like Protel or whatever else that uses a .pcb extension. That can get a little confusing. If you do have a software that opens the .pcb extension, keep that in mind. Altium might have the priority over that, or your other software may have the priority. You may want to uncheck this and then right-click on the .pcb file extension, then choose Open With, then set your software. Other than that, though, the rest of these extensions are pretty good. Oh, also know that when you're exporting .drill files from Allegro or whatever else, Altium is automatically going to associate itself with the DRL file, and it's going to give it that green icon. So if you're used to some other icon for your drill files in another ECAD software, then you look for this icon, okay? New document defaults. There are different defaults that you can choose from, and I like the ANSI B landscape size. You can also do ANSI C. That's pretty cool. And for Hasofu, I like maybe next sheet ANSI. There's so many things you can set here. It's really nice. And then there's the ISO standard. So You can set the revision state whenever you do load it. It's really cool. Those are templates, and then those are some drafts you can work on. Okay, now we've got, that's the new document defaults, and then printer settings. If you want to add specific things like, let me move this thing out of the way. If you want to add specific things like large envelope format or weird formats, then that's fine. Custom page sizes for exporting to PDF. I never touched this. I never really needed to, but you can add specific things if you want. Mouse wheel configuration. This is really cool. This may be the first thing you want to go to. So by default, Altium has a thing where in order to do a vertical scroll, it's the normal wheel thing. And then to do a zoom main window, you have to hit control. So by default, this is what the setting is like. Scroll up and down. Well, okay, I use my middle mouse button to do that, but don't worry about it. Okay, so you can scroll up and down with the mouse wheel. You can hold down your mouse wheel button, and this will zoom in and out. But that's a little weird, although it is very smooth, so that's nice. You can use your right mouse button to pan or drag the thing around, and you use your left mouse button to select and whatnot. But I really like switching that, so I uncheck. Oh, right, one more thing. You hold down the control key and scroll up and down to zoom in and out. I don't like having to hold down the control key to do that. So I would, even though I keep the same setting in ORCAD where I have to hold down the control key, I don't like doing it for Altium. So uncheck that. And then make sure you check control for vertical scroll. Then click OK. Now when I scroll up and down, it goes like that. And if I want a vertical scroll, I hold down the control key and then do like that. What's cool is you don't have to, I never vertical scroll. Like, I never have to do it because I can just do this. All right. Moving on. The installation. Check frequency every 3 days. Global instance installation service, local installation service, blah, blah, blah. Product development. If you want to participate or not participate. I would say participate, you know, it comes in handy, so I don't know why I have that turned off. And then network activity, Altium Portal, Altium Cloud. Yeah. Uncheck if you do not want to receive updates to the nanoboard firmware that's installed in Altium Designer. A lot of these things look like they get installed, like these are options you can check or uncheck during installation. All right, that was a long video, right? That's a system, and you are set for the system. We dipped into data management when we did the template thing, but yeah, that is how you set up your system. Generally, the default settings are good, but the mouse wheel setting you want to change if you have certain preferences. You can change the theme for the board. You can also change the cross-select mode, You can choose if components or NATs can be cross-selected. You can change the default new schematic. You can also change how the system operates. So if you hover like over these icons here, it'll show you a preview of the page. The system refers to the whole software, right? So if you hover over here, then we can control how fast that pops out or if it does an animation or not. The transparency, when we're trying to place a part, like right-click, choose place. Yeah. And then it's loading, so it's really cool. I hit left click to do that. So everything to do with the software in general is the set of settings. This was an extensive video. It's very detailed, I know, but it was based on a request that somebody requested. Okay, thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.